Hello everyone, my name is Aditya and I'll talk about NPA. Particularly talk about the condition of NPA in our country in the upcoming next 3 years. So objective of this presentation will be the introduction of NPA, that is I will talk about its definition, classification, etc. The past trend, what is being there and historically regarding NPA, and the current scenario and future predictions, and finally I'll give the final conclusion. So, the definition of NPA, the non-performing asset is loan or advances which bank give to loans give to corporates or individual. So, suppose if any corporate or individual, they fail to repay loans or let's say interest for over 90 days, then these loans will become NPA. So, this NPA is a very broad term, it's an umbrella term. So, it is further classified into three categories. So, even after NPA, that is after 90 days, if there is no interest for another like next 12 months, then it is called substandard assets. Now, if any asset becomes substandard, then if still the payment is not received till next 12 months, then it will be termed as doubtful assets. Now, if further, if the bank are assured that the loans is never going to be paid back to them, then they categorize them into loss assets. So the looking at the past trends, so RBI always every year releases a report which is named as Trend in Progress of Banking in India. So this report mentions that 7 years of rising NPA shows a decline. More specifically talking, it says that gross NPA from 11.2% in March 2018 got declined to 9.1% in March 2019. So we can understand this better through this graph. So our ex-RBI governor Raghuram Rajan and NDA government decided to recognize loans, bad loans or NPA, which was not done earlier. Because of this initiative, we can see that from 2014, there is a continuous increment in the loans recognized till 2018. In the below graph also, in the right side, we can see that the biggest fall of the NPA of around 9.2% is seen in public sector banks, and there is small decline which is also seen in foreign banks. So the major reason behind the decline is that the biggest role of conducive policy environment which is being created by government policies, laws and legislation along with the RBI, for example, recapitalization, etc. And also there is the introduction of IBC, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, which has helped in a major way. So the current situation, if we see regarding NPA, is that few days back, India Rating and Research, which is a subsidiary of Fitch Group, has published a report studying top 500 biggest biggest private sector companies of India. So these companies took around 440 lakh crore loan and has defaulted of around 7.35 lakh crore from those loans. Now the reason of default is not always due to lenders or borrowers' mistake, malfeasance, corruption, fraud, etc. Can also be due to the slow growth of country's GDP. Further, this report also mentioned the overall corporate loan, which is currently outstanding in our country's account, to 64 lakh crores. So, future predictions. So, this report research also mentions that if the country's GDP fails to see any growth or pickup, and then from this 64 lakh crore, which is the overall corporate loan in a country, additional 4%, that is 2.54 lakh crore default can be seen in a country in the next 3 years. And the assumption which is being taken here is that the average real GDP growth should be around 6% for financial year 21 to financial year 22, with the input cost, that is raw material costs, etc., should not be rising more than 4%, and rupee should not depreciate by more than 5%. So even after, if you see that the average growth GDP growth rises to 7% for the same period, the default still comes to around 2 lakh in the next 2 lakh crore in the next 3 years. So to understand this in a better way, we need to understand the relationship of NPA to GDP. So every business, when they take loan, they predict their project's future outlook, and that is production. If their production increases due to the improved demand, etc., and they will be able to repay loans from their higher revenue. But due to a slowdown or slump in the demand, the companies turn their use of debt from the productive asset to fund their losses. Consequently, the firm loses their ability to repay loans to the banks. Therefore, country's GDP growth is very much related to the NPA growth. This can also be seen from the report, the research done by RBI DPR. So it says that empirically, if there is a 1% decline in the GDP growth, it will raise the NPA by 0.4 percentage point. So coming to the conclusion, now will this affect our economy? The RBI has continuously reduced repo rate to reduce bank charges from loans. But with 2.4 lakh crore default, bank could increase their charges, leading to increased credit cost. Also, banks' profitability will also reduce. So looking overall, looking at both the things together, our economic credit cycle will get a bigger hit. This will put the pressure economy under more pressure, leading to the further slowdown. Thank you.